babies, like all human beings, come with abilities to detect emotion, to detect the emotions of sadness and anger, as well as the emotions of joy and pleasure. Even during the first year of life, a young child, an infant, can be aware of emotions around conflict, can hear the difference in tone in a voice that is yelling or conflictive, as opposed to a voice that is nurturing and kind. And I would also add that we know that that kind of hearing and that kind of assessment of human interaction doesn't just begin at the time of birth, but actually happens during the prenatal period as well. We know, for example, that babies who have spent the 9 months of gestation in their mother's belly can recognize their mother's voice as opposed to other voices that he or she may have heard during that period of time in the womb. Even during prenatal life, but especially during the first year of life and the first several years of life, conflict within the family, yelling and anger, is a form of adversity. It's a form of stress that can affect children's well-being. We know that exposure to that and other kinds of adversity can fundamentally change the development of the child's biology, the circuitry in the brain, the areas of the brain that deal with socio-emotional development, can change even the immune system, can change the way that the body's metabolism is regulated. So all of these experiences of what we think of as toxic stress can, over months and years of time, really fundamentally alter the biology of the child and affect that child's vulnerability to illness and mental disorder, often for the remainder of life.